Hey guys, and welcome back. It's your girl, Yevi.com. Thank you for joining me as always. It is much appreciated. Appreciated is the word I was looking for. I think I'm getting dumber as the years go by. Welcome to 2023, and you know what that means. Top of the year, gotta talk about my husband list for 2023. But this year, I'm gonna try and be as sane and cohesive as possible, if possible. You know what that means. I'm gonna need my handy dandy notebook. Okay, so as the years go by and I get older, my husband list has evolved. And for those of you guys who this is your first husband list video, you should check out the other ones. But basically, in college, I used to do this thing where I had a husband list, and people waited with bated breath to know who I thought was going to rule 2023 with an iron fist. Usually I'm wrong, but it is okay because these people are still super, super hot. This is not necessarily meaning that I want to prospectively marry them or want to have sex with them or all that nasty other stuff or relationships. No, it's just people that I really truly believe in the years coming, or also, yes, I do like their face a lot.
It means I'm going to sit on your dick so hard that you die.
80, you're married.
Che, you know I don't play tag because I've been it.
Lots of options. First up is a general category, actually. I did categories last year, not doing them this year, but this general category had to be on the list because there was too many people to name. It's people with flippable hair. I have a weak spot, okay? I had a man bun phase that is currently reenacting itself right now. We're not gonna talk about it. But besides just the man bun phase, I also have a love of people with like really long flippable hair. I specifically say flippable because I have longish hair, but it's not really flippable. It's 4C curly shit, not easy to flip, David Diggs style, you know what I mean? Like long, luscious, but can be in a mean ponytail, but otherwise not super useful for flipping. So flippable hair is really what's going on. And I have such a list that I had to, you know, write it down and put it in my handy dandy notebook. So anyone with long flippable hair. This includes, but is not excluded to, all the members of BTS when they were going through their hair phase. I'm not sure where we're landing right now, because right now as I'm recording this, Jin has currently shaved his head, going off to the war. See you soon, I'm now a military wife. But his hair in the astronaut video would be an example of lovely flippable hair, even though he did admit that that was a wig sometimes. Suga, oh my god. Before we get to Suga, pin in that. Jungkook, obviously, beautiful long flippable hair.
아씨, 머리를 오늘 라이브 스트리밍이
Jimin is going through a phase. We love it. RM had this long, beautiful hair that he cut short, but I do love RM, cropped or no cropped. It's fine. It's beautiful both ways. But Suga Ray. I've talked at ad nauseum how I love this man. He is my bias. He is my alt bias. I love him. I love him a lot. But any member of BTS when they're in their long hair phase is definitely in this category. Along with like Jungkook from Seventeen, he has this blonde mane that goes on during like I think their Darling era. Darling, obviously he started off with really long hair, and that is long flippable. It's a little too long for me though. But that blonde long thing he had going on, beautiful. Again, S Coops with that half white, half black hairstyle, long and flippable.
For anybody that had a sudden increase of 17 and they're listening this year because I was forcing it on you, I am not sorry. And I will be doing it again. In fact, I'm going to be worse, so.
But other members that belong to this include this character that I don't know. I've never seen the show. I think it is a BL. I just seen him on the memes on my Twitter. And he is a character from a show. I'll put the show's name here. I don't know. I'll put his name here, I don't know, but this is just a montage of him shaking his hair out, and it is so beautiful.
Bye.
Part tied to that, someone who I do know their name is, and also in a BL, Jeff Sitar. He's a beautiful singer. There's no place I could hide. Take me inside and let me live in your mind. No pain tonight. This place reserved for only you and I. Cause I was also in the most popular BL this year, Kim Porsche, and I love his vocals. I've like followed his vocals for a really long time, and his hair growth situation, love it, beautiful, ecstatic about it. Couldn't be more glad, but he is also on this list for his music, yes, but mostly for his football hair. And as we go on, while we are in the realm of Asia, the Asian countries, we are going to move over from K-pop, obviously, and BLs, and obviously, but go to actors, Korean actors. So specifically, Im So-won in Summer Strike. Love his hair. Love him. Right now there's like 2 episodes out. He's a sexy librarian, but I love the length of his hair, as well as Shin Sung-ho. He is in Alchemy of Souls, which is again one of the most popular dramas of this year. He has hair up a lot of the times in that, so like not really that one, but him in Weak Hero, he also has his hair up, but there's something more gritty about him being a bad boy with his hair in his ponytail, especially that one scene where he headbutts the guy. I watched the whole show for that moment alone. I didn't like how it ended. I hated how the show ended. But you know what? I take it. Yeah, I take my wins. A win's a win. A win is a win, as TikTok would say. Then of course we have our actors from here down home in America, or otherwise not America, because there is non-Americans on this, but we're talking Adam Driver, who always has my heart, has been on my husband list before. I love his long luscious locks. I love his big oaky body. I love his face. I love his acting chops. He's so talented and cute and everything. So Adam Driver, yes. Dev Patel, again, another man I have loved for a very long time, and I'm so glad that this is the place where I can voice that. Jeff Bridges, yes, there's no age limit on this list. That Silver Fox with his mane, stunning. I love when he plays like a dirty cowboy role. I love that accent. I have a like accent so much, specifically the southern accent, because I'm from Maryland, so my accent is not strong enough to be southern, because technically we're not the south, but technically we're not the north. It's very difficult, but I love a southern accent, and I love that on him. And then obviously our long-haired king, who did cut his hair, but like I can't follow the timeline of his facial and hair growth, you know, Jason Momoa and anything where his hair is long and luscious. I love that he is following this rock-esque path where it was like he was known for like being this hard-ass wrestler or actor or whatever, and now he's just in these like fun roles. Just fun roles, just doing whatever he wants. If he wants to be a Christmas elf, he do that, whatever. But he's a household name, and we love his long, lovable hair. All that to say is that that's number one category. All those people are in one category. One. Two is another category. I know I said no categories, but this is just, I couldn't name all these girls. I guess there are girls on my husband list. Yes, I am straight, but you know, talent knows no gender. And this is specifically for talent. Like the first one, all looks. Like, yes, they're talented actors, singers, whatever, but all looks for that, because flippable hair.
You're simple, you're shallow, and you're a common whore.
This, the girlies were giving. The girlies gagged and gave. And I'm talking about 3 people girl groups. And I'm talking about, like, not, like, obviously 3LW or anything, but I'm talking, like, recent 3 girl groups, fake and real. So, like, that would include, like, these three I picked three specific girl groups for this category. One is XOIQ. I talk about them a lot. It's a fictional BAM from the group Make It Pop, from the show Make It Pop. It involves Megan, who is one of my favorite YouTubers and songwriters. She wrote, I believe, Villain by Alexa, which I love. Love Alexa, love Megan. And she also sings herself. She's a beautiful voice. I loved them. As a girl group, they were so eclectic. I thought, honestly, I made a video about this and I stick to my guns and saying that, like, a lot of us, like, we got into K-pop either through, like, you know, Girls' Generation, Psy, a lot of that. I think that a lot of us with, like, new BTS fans were prepped for being new BTS fans because of XOIQ. Because they really had, like, a K-pop feel to them as a group. Not because they were mostly Asian, but because, like, the theatrics within their performance, within their dancing, within their singing, like, they were real, okay, to me.
Wait, I'm just getting started here. From his
sneakers to his head, he's like Superman, I swear, and it's YOLO in the air. Another fictional band that I'm mentioning here is Take Three, which is a fictional band from the show Star. RIP, shouldn't have got canceled. So, I mean, the plot lines were getting crazy, but, like, shouldn't have got canceled. Really great show. Hopefully they come back. But they were also super talented. They were the boss bad bitches. We feel good, let that be understood. Do me like you know you should. No, I don't mean no name. I'm haunted by the picture frames. I can almost touch your face. Memories can really be here sometimes. I thought I could walk away. But it ain't that easy, babe, when you're curled up in the lonely every night. We were something, but you were frontin'. Now I'm sitting here wishing I could get you out of my head. Their story started in Atlanta, and they all met up together, formed a girl group. Some people had solo songs. I know all the words to There For You. Yeah, that's it. Just amazing. Amazing talent. But also their group songs, including Madonna, Imagination. They had so many banger after bangers. Banger after banger after banger after morsels of more bangers. They say the time heals all your wounds. I don't know if that's true. No, I know it ain't true. Every good girl got a crazy best friend. Yeah, welcome to my world. Crazy best friend, gay. They say I'm married to the gay. Oh my goodness, oh my gracious. They don't have the mouth to teach us. They don't have the, oh, they don't have the hands to reach us. All the way up here, all the way up here, all the way up here. They look, but they're not gonna reach us from. And especially their performance of Yellow Tape is what really pushed it over the edge, because I loved them dragging a man by his baby hairs, by his little baby chin hairs, whiskers. Boy, you just got bodied by a bunch of ladies, and you gonna have to take it to your grave. Yellow Tape, Yellow Tape, DOA, DOA, took a shot, a mistake. Yellow Tape, Yellow Tape. It was great. Yellow Tape is a song that they wrote in as a diss track to a little deany something pimped down bitch ass band. But they came out and performed and stole his show, and it was amazing. Like, if I can play a clip of it here, I will. But it was great.
Boy, don't you dare disrespect women again. You know where the hell you came from?
Africa.
And what they call that, the fatherland or the motherland?
And then the last girl group is a actual real girl group that broke up, and I feel very sad about it. And I count them as three because fuck that other bitch. That is Little Mix. Little Mix was the band that Fifth Harmony was trying to be for so long, but Fifth Harmony didn't like each other, and no one at Psycho liked Fifth Harmony for some reason. I don't know what was going on with there, but Little Mix, sadly, they never really made it across the pond, even though they should have. Their vocals were insane. Things in my life rain down. Time they made banger after banger after Jessie, whatever her name is, fuck her, left. They were still strong and amazing and talented. Like, they were so talented in their vocals. Cue a montage. Just a touch of your love is enough to knock me up on my feet. Oh, just a touch of your love, just a touch of your love. Broke a couple hearts and I wear on my sleeve. My mama always said, girl, you're troubling. And now I wonder, could you fall for a woman like me? And every time we touch, boy, you make me feel weak. I love sing big, sweet melodies. But the day it did me wrong, the song couldn't go up and up. In their dancing and their performance in every aspect, and they also seem like sweet and genuine people. And I feel so bad I didn't get to Little Mix until like later. I feel like I didn't get into them because of Perry's relationship with Zayn. I was one of those DeLulu queens who was like, they're fake, I know they're fake, but it's like, I don't, why did I even care? Like, why? I wasn't gonna date Zayn. He wasn't even my favorite. It was Nile. I was a Nile girl. I never really got super, super into them. And now that I am into them, they broke up. Like, and it makes me sad, but they made so much great music. Their Wings era, they started off with Wings as a debut single, which was amazing. They're not the first British girl group to break my heart. Won't be the last. Next up on the list is an actual person. The rest of these are people, I swear. And then I'll have like one little extra asterisk person. It's a girl, but it's because of a specific thing. But besides that, we'll go to the next person, who is Winston Duke. If you don't know Winston Duke, he is M'Baku about to blow your M'back out.
M'Baku could blow my M'back out if he wanted to.
M'Baku forever.
That is his Twitter handle. No, I'm kidding. It's not. But he did play M'Baku in both of the Black Panther movies.
You cannot talk. One more word, and I will feed you to my children. I'm kidding, we are vegetarians. If my soldiers were present, this fishman would be bound before us as we speak.
If your muscle brains were present, they would still be there, choking on their fuzzy adornments.
You ball-headed demon.
He was amazing. He was beautiful. He was phenomenal. He can crush melons with his thighs, which is just outstanding.
If you want to get crazy, we can get crazy.
Outstanding, sir. But more than that, he is funny and super witty in all of his interviews. And I love that about him. I love that he respects Black women.
I always say, I've learned a lot of my dream chasing from women. It's like, I came to this country to pursue, you know, my sister's dream of being a doctor. That's right. Why we came here.
Oh.
And then, Trinidad and Tobago.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then the first person I saw, she's Trinidadian, I think. The first person I saw in my cohort to make it was Lupita Nyong'o.
Yes. Yes.
And like, I started, yes, like, even following, you know,
the blueprint.
You went
to Yale Drama School.
With, yeah, her.
With her.
And, you know, was watching her blueprint, and it's now I'm watching women like Issa Rae, like, you know, Rihanna.
Follow the ladies. Follow the ladies.
No, the women. Yeah, it's always the ones who have it the hardest who create the clearest blueprint.
I love that he, like, really plays his character Satie. He's, like, comic relief, joy, beautifulness that I really do embody and love. I do love Winston Duke with my whole ass heart. In the same vein, we are going to go to my next one, who is Aldis Hodge. If you don't know Aldis Hodge, where the fuck have you been? I'm so sorry. He is most recently in the rock superhero movie, Black Adam, I believe. He is Black Adam. I think he's playing Hawk in Black Adam most recently. But I first knew him. I know, like, I like to say, I knew you when. I first knew him as a character in the show Leverage. I'll be talking about Leverage in a different video. But Leverage was a show I watched solely because the first name of the first episode is The Nigerian Job.
They say don't go chasing Nigerian falls.
Which is hilarious to me because I'm Nigerian. And it was, there's just one scene where the guy's like, the white guy's like, Nigerians. Nigerians will do nicely. And I'm like, what is going on? And from there on, I just, like, really just dug into the show. I've rewatched it all the time on Amazon Prime. And it's just so good. It's such a good show. But regardless of that, he is such a great actor.
Chicago, where you drank 17 tiny margaritas, you took your pants off, you stood up on the drink cart, and you sang, quote, I'm a sexy monkey.
He played the violin in that one scene in Leverage, and that really won me over as well. He was just such a sweet, sweet man, Age of the Geek, baby. And then he went on to play other roles. I had forgot about him, not forgotten, but, like, I focused on other things. You know, I'm really into my K-pop era, so I focused on a lot of other things other than him. But he came back in the vengeance in The Invisible Man, and that's where I was like, the man's arms could break me, and I would say thank you. Also, he's a talented actor.
Ma'am, you are brilliant, you are black, and you are a woman, which means you are high fashion.
Very talented. He was amazing in that. He was amazing in a lot of roles. But even before Invisible Man, actually, he was in a movie called Clemency, and that's when I was like, I was crying. I watched it at Sundance, and I was crying real, actual tears.
You've given me hope. I can't do this on my own anymore.
Because the movie was so moving, and his character was so touching, and he played it so amazingly, and I just felt for him as a character, as an actor. I got to see them talk about it. Like, it was amazing. But outside of that, yeah, and then again, Invisible Man, and then more stuff, more and more, and most recently, and he's in Black Adam as a Hawk.
Just say Shazam, we all go home.
There is no we here. There are only heroes and there are villains. Heroes don't kill people.
Which is great. I'm glad that he's doing more and more stuff. I think he's super underrated. I think more people should cast him because he's amazing. Next up, we have... this I have to explain. This I have to explain because it's not the person, it's the character. There's a character that I really loved so much. And in honor of the last iteration of this kind of show getting canceled, I was like, I gotta rehash my love for Klaus Mikkelsen. I love Klaus. I love him so much. Klaus Mikkelsen, if you don't know, he was originally in The Vampire Diaries as one of the original vampires and the Invisible Hybrid. Then he moved on to get his own show called The Originals that was set in my godforsaken favorite place, New Orleans. The one place I want to visit. I would really like to marry someone with the last name Babineau from New Orleans. It's kind of my goal in life. If I can't get there, I'll settle for Sugar from BTS. But if I could, Babineau from New Orleans. If your last name is Babineau and you're from New Orleans, call me. Text me. Don't text me. Slack me. Don't slack me. What the fuck? Tweet me. That's what I meant. Sorry. But I get frazzled when I think about it. But I loved Klaus. And then from there on, Legacies, which is the one that recently got canceled, follows the story of his daughter that he had, Hope. Hope Andrea Michelson. But we're not here to talk about that bitch. We're here to talk about Klaus, okay? He was amazing. He was strong. He was forward thinking. He always had a plan, but he was very emotional. One of my favorite things about him is that he really cared for his family, no matter how terribly he showed it. I remember that one scene where they had the stand-in Cole. I call him stand-in Cole, but his real name is something else. I call him Fake Cole because I like the original Cole better. But he was talking to his brother and he had this beautiful scene. Playing clip here.
I'm not gonna kill you, you idiot. Despite your behavior, you're still my brother.
Just the one you dagger repeatedly.
I've daggered all of you, each for your own good. If you don't agree with my motives, fine. I never claimed to be the bastion of temperance, but stop this drivel about being singled out and unloved. You are a Michelson. You're my blood. And I need you.
It was amazing. His whole dynamic with his daughter was amazing in the last season. I was really sad when he died. Spoiler alert, he dies. But it is... He's an amazing character. I also like the way he treated Caroline. I like that he called her love. And so that really started that kick for me. So I had to play homage to that man at this moment. Next, we have Raul Caholi. He's getting into more roles now, but I originally saw him as the geeky mortician in iZombie.
Are you from London?
Camden.
Ah, Arsenal territory. I'm from Upton Park.
West End boy, is it?
Well, I suppose it could be worse. You could support Millwall.
You could support Tottenham. Or Chelsea.
That was the first time I saw him. He may have been in other things, and maybe I missed it, but that was the first time I personally saw him. He was so endearing and lovable and British. And you know, your girl loves an accent. So, I typically don't really, like, love British accents, but, like, Klaus and Raoul, I don't know, something about them just... clicks in my brain. But he, sweetheart in that show. He seems like a really sweetheart whenever I see interviews of him. He was in Midnight Mass recently, which he covered his accent in, I believe, and it was so good.
We'll drop the charge, help you out. You go to the mosque and listen. I thought we were supposed to be fighting terrorists. Not flipping some pothead student in Queens to spy on Americans. So, I complain. Gently. One time. Everything changed.
I think he was in something else recently. I can't remember what it is, but he was also amazing in that. So he's an amazing actor. He's super hot. And he has an accent. Next is Mo Gilligan. Mo Gilligan, if you don't know him, he is a hilarious comedian from another British man across the pond.
My biggest fear is getting cramped right now.
Yeah.
I live in fear of just getting cramped randomly. Because what can be happening? We could be talking right now.
Can't play that out.
Yeah, we could be like, oh, bruv, this Brexit situation.
Yo.
But this one's a comedian. I love Mo Gilligan. He's a very funny man. He hosted the Late Ish show, which famously my favorite scene from that show is when he asked Katherine Ryan, who is another one of my favorite people in the world, to rap Three Blind Mice, and it was phenomenal and amazing. He also does this bit where he was like doing Big Boss or Shark Tank, and he was like a Nigerian boss, and he used a pitch to him, and he would just do, it's so sweet, make it sweet, that is.
It'd be Lord Sugar. I gotta spice it up though, I'm in his green suit.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll do a Nigerian version. I am sugar. Sweet, sweet sugar. And one of you apprentice is losing me money. So, who should I fire and banish to hell?
I fucking die laughing. Whenever I'm having a bad day, I literally play that clip and I just like laugh my ass off. He was so super amazing. He also does, like, I love stand-up comedians. You don't have to involve music, but, like, last year on my list was Bo Burnham, so obviously tells you where my head is at. I love when comedians can, like, have another talent within them, and he is really good at, like, making these fun songs, like the Geezer song. Mercy. We like the blood clot, Truman Allen, Mercy. I never do your like Ghost on Tasha. I never do your like Ghost on Tasha. I never do your like Ghost on Tasha. Grand? Because I'm the pom pom masher. The pom pom masher. The pom pom masher. Mash up the pom. I'm the pom pom masher. Pom pom masher. Pom pom masher. Mash up the pom. I'm the pom pom masher. See me, mate. I'm a top geezer. Get two cans, mate. Chuck them in the freezer. Get two cans for Sally and Lisa. Get two cans for Sally and Lisa. Fuck it up. Fuck it up. Jack and Jill. Go up at the inn. Yeah. To fetch a bucket of some water. In feed his daughter. In feed his daughter. Hey, because she's thirsty. Now me say free blind mice, free blind mice. Them a look for the cheese, but they can't find the slice. Hey. No cheese, feed them, feed them, feed them. Hey, because they're lactose intolerant. And I really do love watching it. It makes me happy and giggle all the time. So he's on the list. Next, we have to talk about Lee Junction, since we're talking about music, I guess. Lee Junction most famously was in, most recently was in Shooting Star. Shooting Star is a drama. It was all about the acting industry, the K-drama industry. This guy who's famous and his PR lady who he falls in love with. Great, beautiful dandy. On the side, the second lead guy is a beautiful lawyer who is played by Jungshin, and he's scrumdiddlyumptious. 관심 없는 사람이랑 술 안 마십니다. 게다가 황금 같은 퇴근 시간 이외에는 더더욱이요. 그 말은 즉 기쁨 씨한테 충분히 많습니다. 관심. 지난번에 술 마셨으니까 오늘은 저녁 먹어요 우리. 모두 윤리정 지키시죠. 사람이 숨어갔습니다. 달려 내려. 전 오늘 기자님이 좀 멋졌습니다. 기자님이 쓴 기사도요. 유일하게 좋아요 눌렀어요. 내 태양의 내일을 걸어봐. 따라오라고. 우리는 drop it like hard. Hot, hot, 어지간 feeling so hot. 이 노래 burning like hot, 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 hot. 이게 drop like hot, 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 어지간 feeling so hot. Yeah, I'm running too hot, 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 hot. Let's get young, young, hell. 불 붙여라, 아주 뜨, 뜨, yeah. He's very beautiful, very level-headed, very sweet. He ends up with her best friend. And they are, honestly, they could have their own spin-off series and I would watch it because they were so good. He's just lovely. And I wondered, why did I love him so much? Why did I feel like I connected with him so much? He is also in the band CNBLUE, which I didn't remember the band, but they had a song called Loner, which I loved and didn't realize was the band. And yes, he was in that group. He's just so talented. He also used to have long clippable hair, which is a plus. If you're looking for a wife, this is one of the few times on my husband list that I am saying I am available.
What is reality?
For marriage.
이걸 앞에 두고 양장피?
진짜 내가 양장피 먹고 싶다 그래서 해주는 거예요?
아니, 내가 먹고 싶어서.
그러시겠지. 저기, 근데 어제 새벽에 혹시
한 좀 봐. 네 입맛에 맞나.
On the other spectrum, not so much looking for marriage, but listen, Kenny JD said it herself.
I'm not looking for a father figure, but I am looking for a daddy.
Daddy. Daddy, 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 daddy. And it's weird that I call him daddy because he's literally only, like, I think like a month or two and a half older than me, legally. I think he's like a month and a half older than me, but we're talking about Escoop. From 17. Now, S Coops from 17, I love that man. I love him. I have a photo card of him on my desk to inspire me to work hard every day so that I could be rich enough to get a private concert from S Coops and just see him sing Cheers to me over and over again.
돈 많이 벌어와서 나 먹여 살려 빨리 벌어와. 집에 있을 테니까 돈 벌어와. 무엇보다 힘이 나지 않아?
Selfish man, making everyone fall in love with you, and for fucking what? Getting everyone in the front row pregnant, and for fucking what, dude?
Shout out to my friend Olivia who got me this. I don't know if you can. I'm going pom pom. I love his scoops. I love him. He is so genuinely hilarious and charismatic. He's the leader of 17, he's the leader of the rap line. He's a rapper, of course. A rapper from Daegu, just my type. Do I have a type? Yes. But I love him. He's my bias in 17. He's slowly becoming one of my alt biases. Sweet, kind, has a temper on him. And that's where I'm like, I don't know if I want to marry that temper, but I sure could give birth to your kids.
We are paying the rent for these people, all right? For what? They're 9 to 5s. They clock in and out. That's what being an idol is. It's a job. These guys, gals, and dolls in between? They are not gods. They are not special than the rest of us just because they are hot and they make a lot more money. So guess what I want all of you to do for 2023? I want y'all to have that mindset and I want you to start airdropping NDAs. I want you to bring the NDAs to them. I want you to flip the script. I want you to have pens inscribed. I want to see some of you with a VIP account on DocuSign because that's the energy that y'all deserve. That's the energy that we all deserve, okay? It's no longer a one-way street. Let's change that for 2023. It's not, how do I serve my favorite K-pop artist? How do I get to them? No, no, no. How do they get to you?
He is my bias. He is so, so fine. So fine. It's the puffy lips. It's like the puffy lips. I love the hair. I love the teeth. I love his teeth. His teeth make me so happy when he smiles. I love that he laughs audibly, like ha ha ha. He says ha ha in his laugh, and that's hilarious to me. And then also like they always compare it to a camel, and it, like I'm like, that's the sexiest camel I've ever seen.
We're getting canceled.
We should have not been brought here today.
The intrusive thought.
You're gonna cancel
this. This was the whole thing was a mistake.
I'm a lady, and I do have moral standards to uphold. I know that was just for us.
Sorry, it's so inappropriate. But yes, I love S-Coops.
Oh,
I guess you could say I have a type, literally rappers from Daegu that like to lick their lips when they perform a lot, I guess you could say is my type. And that being my type, you know, the last person on this list is BTS. But before we get there, I'm gonna give you my honorable mention. My honorable mention is Miss BB herself. She is a singer, songwriter, rapper-ish kind of a vibe, R&B heavy artist from South Korea, obviously. She's hilarious. All of her songs can almost never be played on Korean TV because they're very inappropriate for Korean TV, like her song Cigarettes and Condoms, literally. She also has like music like Be New. She also writes a lot of songs. She wrote for Twice. She writes for a lot of people, but she also has her own singing thing going on that she is very, very, very talented at. She's amazing at it. She dropped a new album this year that I'm really listening to, digging to, vibing to. It's called Low Life Princess, and I'm like listening to the noir one, Low Life Princess Noir. I love it. All her music videos are super artistically beautiful. Well done, well done. Shameless friends are mine. She has these two dots that she puts on her face when she performs to honor her grandfather. She also like gives no fucks about anything and literally like gave this lap dance that broke the internet, and I think that's hilarious and have to give her flowers for that. I'd like to see her as her own person, but she also does give big Jackson Wang energy. If you know, you know. But back to the last actual group, it's BTS, our boys in purple. They are going off to the war soon, so they probably won't be on my husband list next year. I mean, who's to say? They probably will be. But I do want to like give them a special like flowers. Thank you for everything you've done. Have fun in the military, I guess you could say. I am a military wife now. But yes, BTS, they all have also been dropping solo problems. You know, the problems for me because I don't have that much money. Solo projects, which is like very smart for HYBE because they're, you know, they get their hiatus, they get a break finally before they have to like enlist and all these things. But then they also are all doing like solo stuff. So like, you know, RM dropped Indigo, J-Hope dropped Jack in the Box, Jin dropped Astronaut. They have been flying all over the globe like some weirdos, so it makes me suspicious. But it is a smart job for HYBE because now they're getting like, instead of getting that one check from like BTS as a whole, they're getting 7 separate checks for all their solo projects before they go off to the war. And I'm glad that they got the chance to relax and like really, you know, do their own thing. Also, their Busan concert made me die inside a little bit. It was so beautiful and magnificent. They literally broke the internet with Run BTS, which is still, again, one of my favorite new BTS songs. Like, it's one of the best. Like, yes, Yet to Come is emotional and beautiful. Yes, Dynamite broke barriers for them. Yes, I have a Funko Pop of Butter Sugar. Yes, okay. All those things are true. But Run BTS pays homage to like the dark and wild side of BTS. So seeing them perform that at the Busan concert was amazing in general. And all of the songs that they performed were amazing. And I will miss the boys as much as possible. 17 is keeping my bed warm for you. But when you get back, call me. And of course, Suga, again, rappers from Daegu that like to lick their teeth. Mouth, lips, whatever. Love them for that. That is my husband list for 2023. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for being here. And don't worry, guys, I'll be back, so stay tuned.